rental property investing. Unlock the secrets of real estate investing and management, including tips on negotiation and finding investment properties that will give you passive long-term income. Written by Charles Pennyfeather. Narrated by Brian R. Scott. Introduction. When it comes to real estate investment properties, the first thing that might pop into your mind is your home. However, residential real estate can play a significant role in any successful and diversified portfolio. When you invest in real estate, most often referred to as leased property and as a tangible asset, you get a secure and interactive investment opportunity that enables you to expand your financial portfolio. Furthermore, having a rental property is a safe and excellent means to grow your wealth. Rental property investment and management can be as simple as playing a game of Monopoly, as long as you master the fundamental factors of economics, finance, and risk. To succeed, you have to purchase properties, avoid bankruptcy, and generate rent so that you can buy more properties. But don't forget that simple doesn't mean easy. If you make a mistake, the result can span from minor to major disasters. You may even find yourself broke or worse. In this audiobook, you will learn the secrets that successful investors use to run their property investments. The first chapter details the basics and responsibilities of becoming a landlord. Next, you will learn how to find investment properties that can provide both short-term and long-term rental income. Once you have mastered the different strategies, you will then learn how to run the actual property. Following on from this, you will discover how to add value to your rental property, including how to build a successful business model. The fourth and fifth chapters focus on how to analyze your rental property and the different ways you can finance your property respectively. The sixth chapter delves into the best methods to negotiate deals. You will learn why listening is critical when you need to start a negotiation and why you should use mirrors in your conversation. The final chapter concentrates on the best secrets of rental property investing and management. Most importantly, how to choose the right plan, how to select members for your rental investment team, and how to manage your rentals and exit strategies. Lastly, you will learn about the mistakes to avoid in rental property investment. Whether you are new to rental property investing or organizing your third income property, this audiobook has great nuggets of advice. Time to dive in. Chapter 1. Becoming a landlord. Becoming a landlord can be a great option for increasing your wealth. If this is your plan, here are some solid first-time pointers. Be ready for the kind of work involved. From screening for tenants to filling out legal agreements to taking care of utilities, it is crucial to know what you are getting yourself into. As a landlord, you need a real estate lawyer to assist you in dealing with any legal problems that might occur. Different federal and state laws deal with rental matters, such as security deposits, lease agreements, discrimination, late rental payments, and maintenance. If you own a property that you would like to rent out, but you don't want to deal with the everyday tasks, then look for a property management company. You will need to work hard to get the right tenants. If your tenants turn out to be bad choices, then you need to be ready to evict them. Own a rental home, the journey to wealth. According to a report by the National Association of Realtors 2017 Investment and Vacation Home Buyer Survey, in 2016, investment property increased from 1.09 million to 1.14 million. Working as a landlord can take different forms, but you can be entirely free, allowing others to do all the work for you. Or you can be your own boss and gradually grow your net worth. However, it is not for everyone. Do you have the skills and experience it takes? Only a few newbies find it easy to become a landlord. For many, it is just hard work. Some experience problems, especially when the economy and market aren't running well. That is when tenants begin to fail to pay the rent. If you have lived in a rented house or apartment, you may have never met your landlord. That is because he or she may have chosen to let other people maintain and manage the property. Alternatively, your landlord may have lived in one of the rooms in your building, So you may have met or passed each other every day without knowing. Or they may have done all tasks and responsibilities, like repairing a leaky faucet. The primary tasks of a landlord. Where the landlords decide to do everything on their own or appoint others to do it, they still have the primary responsibility for many tasks, such as finding the right tenants. 1. Advertising for new tenants. You'll soon learn how to get in touch with your target market. However, today's online platform provides local classified advertising, like Craigslist, that is considered cost-effective. 2. Filing legal agreements. You need to have a lease agreement for every rental. Crucial items to include in a lease are clear statements that show who is responsible for different tasks, such as maintaining of the yard to ensuring upkeep of appliances. 3. You can let your attorney create one, or you could build yours on a template from a certified website. 4. Disclosing the home to potential clients. This is generally a sales chance that can help reduce the dead time that occurs between tenants. However, this is a chance to clear away potential clients that don't qualify. 5. Vet renters to avoid vandals and deadbeats. Different companies, some on the internet, provide credit and verification checks to the landlord. Managing your property. 1. Collecting the rent and deposits. Don't forget this. 2. Set and enforce rules. The most successful landlords like to implement rules rigidly. Tenants have no option but to abide by the rules and regulations. 3. Solving insurance and liability issues. These may include swimming pools, icy paths, and ensuring that the home is up to standard. 4. Maintaining books and monitoring tax write-offs. Ensure that you can claim all the deductions created for you. 5. Observing local landlord-tenant laws. The only thing worse than being in court is losing in court. 6. Maintain the correct records for legal and tax purposes. You never know when the court and IRS will ask you for such details. It is good to try out only those tasks and responsibilities for which you believe you have the time and skills. However, the work that you outsource will cost you and reduce the gains of your venture. Accidental rental or professional aspiration. Some people are born into being a landlord, attain the position, or have it thrust upon them. This means they either inherit a rental property, purchase it, or become landlords unexpectedly. Those who become a landlord by accident are usually homeowners who had to move to a different location, probably for family reasons or work, but could not sell their house. This could have been because they had negative equity, or the local property market was poor and nobody was buying. Hence, to ensure they have the money, they had to rent out the original home. Tenant proofing. This is usually good for the renter because the tenant gets to live in a homeowner's pride and joy. However, if the tenant doesn't take good care of the home, as well as the owner, that can easily change. The pride and joy may quickly turn into a pigsty. To deal with this risk, some landlords tenant-proof their properties. It could mean repairing destroyed hardwood flooring using inexpensive carpets and linoleum, while also removing weak aspects that may have been abused, such as a wood stove. That said, tenant-proofing should be considered in the form of content marketing. If you want to attract high-end renters that will pay for quality services, then they need some luxury. If people in your target market are interested in a roof over their heads, your goal should be to secure the value of your asset. Professional help. As a landlord, some people think that they can do all the above tasks by themselves. Although some succeed, many people don't find enough time in a day, especially when they have another job. They may also lack the skills to perform all the necessary maintenance and repair work. Thus, they decide to look for a professional to assist them. The few who may not have the time to choose go for a full-time service property management company, which will manage all the tasks on their behalf. The cost for property management depends on the current local market, the task that they want to avoid, and whether the rental...
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.